Welcome back to Metal Injection's Countdown. On this edition, we'll be revisiting the most shocking moments in heavy metal history. From murders and lawsuits to animal decapitation, our esteemed panel of metalheads will look back at the 10 most controversial moments in metal.
The lead singer of the metal band As I Lay Dying was arrested Tuesday after authorities say he tried to hire someone to kill his estranged wife. Tim Lambesis, the frontman to this Grammy-nominated metal band, was arrested and charged with murder at a retail store in Oceanside, California, after authorities suspected he tried to hire an undercover detective posing as a killer for hire. The San Diego County Sheriff's Department learned of that plot last Thursday and started an investigation. And arraignment is set for Thursday afternoon.
Allegedly, Tim wanted to have his wife killed so that he could have full custody of his children. And he was talking to a hitman who ended up being an undercover cop named Red. And the way that Tim got arrested was he showed up with, you know, a deposit for the hit and like photos and info about his wife to give to the hitman to potentially murder his estranged wife. And it turned out he was an undercover cop, and then he got arrested.
When we got the email, I thought it was a prank. I didn't think it was real. Everyone seems to have gotten really hung up on the fact that he was a Christian, and therefore this is that much more offensive or maybe just hypocritical. But nobody really seemed to get hung up on the fact that it's so unmetal to hire somebody to kill your wife. Like, remember when Varg fucking killed somebody himself. That's what you do in metal.
You know, like black metal, they have the murdering and stuff, and this is like the Christian bands who are like, hey, we could murder too, you know? It's like, it's not just all the Satanists doing the murdering.
I was a religious dude for a long time, but nowadays, in the last, you know, maybe decade of my life, I've started to see some of the most religious people are some of the craziest people sometimes. And they do crazy stuff, man. We don't know what happened. I don't know. Maybe it's a crazy story. He's saying his ex-wife's brothers in the forests out there in San Diego, Carlsbad County, whatever that is. I don't know any conspiracy theories. All I know is that $1,000 to hire someone to kill your wife. You know, I'm married. I would think that would be a lot more money.
And the story just keeps getting stranger and stranger. There's still been no conclusion. You know, there's still court dates set, and who knows what's going to happen.
What possibly could have led this devout Christian rock star astray? His lawyer says it was roid rage.
His thought processes were dramatically impacted by the steroid use.
This is a really hard case to speculate on one way or the other because we just don't know enough about it just yet. The one thing that we do know is that the band name has suffered a lot of damage throughout the case, and it might be irreversible, which is really unfortunate to think about how much time and effort that they really put into it.
In this particular case, it's kind of hard for me to be objective. You know, when you know someone and you're friends with them, you're close with them, and you have something like this kind of come completely out of left field. I mean, the only thing I could say is, you know, if whatever happened, at least no one actually did get hurt.
My temptation is to say everyone's innocent until proven guilty. It's my hope that he is innocent, that maybe it was a setup, but the evidence that at least has been released publicly is pretty damning, and you know, what do you say about it?
Lambesis pleaded not guilty to solicitation of murder on Thursday from behind a glass partition in a courtroom packed with supporters. The rocker's attorney claimed he had no intention of harming anybody and was the apparent victim of a setup by the man at the gym.
I think the fact that the band is still together is interesting as well. I can only imagine what their publicity team is going through, what the label and what everybody involved with that band is going through, especially the band members that have nothing to do with this. It seems they made a conscious decision to stay as a band, to not make any sort of statement really, until they find out what the verdict is. And I think that's fair.
My thoughts are out with those dudes, you know, Jordan, Phil, Nick, and Josh. Four of the sweetest guys that, you know, we've probably met in 10 years of doing Metal Injection. So I really hope that they come back either with this or in other endeavors.
This is heavy metal with a Christian twist. frontman Tim Lambesis bangs out lyrics like, "I must be reborn."
Kind of sucks that whenever something really shitty happens in metal, that's when CNN comes calling. That's when it was on all the mainstream news sites as, you know, oh, Christian metal singer tries to have his wife killed.
People definitely want to read about this. It's definitely something that has been one of the biggest stories we've had all year, certainly. Anytime there's anything relating to the Tim Lambesis trial, our site is swarmed with traffic.
I think the bigger crime, aside from like trying to plot the murder of your wife or your ex-wife, is their music. That's the greater crime, the shitty music.
Tim Lambesis should have prayed for a better hit.